Hi, Jenny. How are you today?
I'm good, Lyle. How are you?
Good, good, good. Well, the cooler temperatures outside likely means it's approaching, I hate to say, snow. But
Yeah, maybe, but
yeah, let's not talk snow though, because the big fun-filled day coming up at the end of October, aka Halloween, is fast approaching. And I'm going to share my screen, Jenny, and then we'll just talk with our viewers. All I did today was I just went and did a Halloween costume images search. So you'll see right up here, that's all I did, and brought up all these wonderful images of Halloween costumes. And I thought, moms and dads are probably out there picking costumes, and let's give them a few tips what kind of is good and what maybe we'd recommend to change to make it a safe Halloween.
sounds good. Well, when I think of taking my kids out, it's always looking at some of the costumes have masks, and sometimes they're easy to see out of. Sometimes they're the tiniest little holes. Sometimes they can't see side to side. So thinking about if they are going out trick-or-treating, are they able to see, and are they able to kind of safely get around and not trip over things too? So that would be something for masks, as well as even just the bulkiness of some costumes or any capes if they're too long or things like that. I was thinking of those sorts of things.
Well, and here's a Shutterstock image that again we just went on Google and grabbed off of there. And so it's exactly that. If we look at, and I hope everyone can see, if we look at this little character here, this little red devil, great costume, or this character next to him, again, great costume. But you're right, masks make it hard to see, sometimes hard to hear. I always worry about things like this, like a prop. So you give a child who's got a prop something to carry with a treat bag and a costume that maybe, and these aren't too long, so they're not going to trip over. But I mean, what do they do if they need to open the bag and use two hands to sort of hold it at the door, sort of thing? The pitchfork might end up by the wayside, or
Exactly. It's maybe just not that practical for going out and about for sure.
absolutely, Jenny. It's probably not the best choice of things that we could have. If I look at this image here. This one right here, it's got a bunch of, and again, it's just a Google quick image. It's got lots of characters. Again, face masks are advisable, probably again, once again this year as we had everybody out. But it's just trying to choose a costume that is bright, is light, like on a morning that's cold or Halloween time, that you can put over, say, layers, something that they can see. So really, this image is kind of one of my kind of favorites right away, is because we've got hats, we've got face paints, something that's easy to wear. It's bright, it's light, and it's fun for the kids.
Exactly. And thinking of those maybe who have a darker costume and that's really what they want, there's also things like reflectors or having like glow sticks if you're out kind of when it's darker, things that can help them be seen while they're out trick-or-treating as well, that can, if they really want that costume that's not super bright as well.
Yeah, and that's really easy to go. Head over to the fabric store, or maybe even one of our local bike dealers that has those reflective strips that you can stick on. Sometimes our local hardware stores have them as well. And again, you can just grab. Here's a nice cute picture. These are all these kids that are all dressed up. Costumes that are easy to put on. Treat bags that are easy to handle. Fun costumes like a hat over something. And again, we got to be mindful that in our type of the world, the snow world is quite possible. And so we want to make
Yes,
sure that
so
kids are safe.
definitely. And if it is colder, like even mitts that'll go with the costume, or buying it a little bit bigger so they could dress in layers underneath and stay warm as well if they are out.
Yeah, absolutely. Here's a bunch of cuties again, somewhere in our Google Images search. That we've come up with. And we should remind that, Halloween is not only for kids. We'll find lots of adults that are dressed up. Make sure that if you are dressing up as an adult and you have to, say, drive to work or drive to a gathering afterwards, try not to be that ghost with the whole thing all dressed up as you're trying to navigate your car to get around. And again, it's always a reminder, folks, as if you are an adult and you are out enjoying Halloween this year, please do plan a safe ride home and limit your beverages if you are planning to get somewhere safely.
Exactly. Great tips, Lyle.
Well, Jenny, thank you very much once again. I wish you a good rest of your week. Maybe any hints as to what the boys are going to be for Halloween this year at your house?
Well, I have one homemade costume from my older son, and the other one is going to be having something maybe from Star Wars kind of coming out. So again, right, that's a classic, many different classic characters. We'll maybe post those later.
Yeah, hey, that'd be great to see. And folks, invite us. Please feel free to share and add your comments either on our Facebook or on our Twitter accounts as we share this video of what your child is looking like for Halloween. It'd be great to see those as well. Good chatting with you once again, Jenny. So have a good rest of your day.
Thank you.